Next continuation for IUPAC nomenclature of the organic compounds. Now our discussion is alkane and alkyl group. So here we need to discuss about what is alkane functional group and what is alkyl functional group, and I will give some names of alkanes and alkyl groups. Now look here, general molecular formula of alkanes. Alkanes is CnH2n plus 2. Here n may be 1, 2, 3 and so on. Now look here, IUPAC name of alkanes is, it is fixed one, alkanes only. Alk plus N is equal to alkanes, alkane. Alkane is the IUPAC name of the alkanes. All these are saturated compounds. Alkanes are saturated compounds. Saturated means what? They have only single bonds. See, alkanes, due to presence of single bond and non-polarity, they are very less reactive. So other name is paraffins. Paraffins is nothing but less reactive species. Now what is alkyl group? Very simple. If you remove, see here, alkane representation is RH. Now alkyl group means, from alkane group, if we remove one hydrogen, if you remove, then R group we will get. This is called alkyl group, and this is alkane. So if we remove one hydrogen from alkane, then we will get alkyl group. Both are saturated one. Now for suppose if I take CH4, one carbon is there, that's why this name is methane. If I remove one hydrogen, then what we will get? CH3. This is called methyl, alkyl, methyl, one carbon is there. Now CH3, two carbons are there, that's why ethane. If we remove one hydrogen, then it is CH3CH2-. This is called alkyl, means what? Two carbons are there, ethyl. Now for suppose if I take four carbons, CH3 CH2 CH2 CH3, how I am writing carbons and hydrogens, I already discussed in basic organic chemistry. Carbon valence is 4, so according to valency of carbon, I am filling hydrogen atoms. 4 carbons are there. This name is butane. Types of hydrogens, how many hydrogens are there? These and these primary hydrogens, these and these secondary hydrogens. I can write two types of alkyl groups. One hydrogen I will remove from primary hydrogen, CH3 CH2 and CH2 CH2-. See, this is one type of alkyl group. Another type of alkyl group I will write CH3. Any one of the secondary hydrogen I will remove, CH2 CH and CH3. This type of alkyl group we will get. See, what is the name of the alkyl group? Both are butyl groups. See, what type of butyl group it is? Four carbons are there, butyl group. We will start numbering from this carbon. one to longest chain we need to consider. So at one position substitution is methyl, that's why one methyl three carbons are there, propyl. One methyl and three carbons are there, this is propyl. So this link is called one methyl propyl. See, another one more example I will discuss and I will close it. Now look here CH3 and CH3. What is the name of this compound? Longest chain we need to consider 1, 2, 3, and this is the substituent. So substituent presented second position, that's why 2-methyl propane, 3 carbons are there, 2-methyl propane. I can remove hydrogens from this. How many types of hydrogens are there here? It is primary, it is also primary, it is tertiary hydrogen atom. See, I will remove one of the primary hydrogen, then CH3 CH and CH3 and CH2 dash. Now come here one more tertiary hydrogen I will remove, then what type of alkyl group we will get? That is the main important factor. Now look here carbon dash. Now this name is what? This is directly attached carbon to the parent chain, and it is first carbon, longest chain we need to consider, and this is the longest chain. The name is what? This is the longest chain, 1, 2, 3. The name is what? 2-methyl. Why 2-methyl? Another extra methyl group is present at second carbon, 2-methyl propyl. Now come here, this is first carbon. Why here hydrogen is removed? This is the first carbon and it is second carbon. At first carbon 2 methyl groups are there, that's why 1, 1 dimethyl ethyl. Why ethyl? Longest chain is what here? This is the longest chain. So 1, 1 dimethyl ethyl. I hope you understand. See, for you one more example I will take and I will close it. Now look here, one more example I am taking, this CH3 CH2 and CH2 CH2 CH3. Total 5 carbons I taken here. See here, I will write different types of alkyl groups from this. See, first type I am writing, one of the hydrogen I am removing, CH3 CH2 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 dash. Here one of the terminal hydrogen I removed. Next, one more hydrogen. See, for understanding purpose I will give numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, at first carbon I removed hydrogen. Now next carbon I am removing hydrogen, CH3 CH2 and CH2, then CH dash and CH3. I removed at second carbon. Now third carbon, I will remove hydrogen from third carbon, CH3 CH2 CH dash and here CH2 CH3. Now these three types of structures we will get, these three types of alkyl groups we will get from pentane. So this name is what, students? Pentane. So from pentane, three types of alkyl groups we will get. These three types of alkyl groups we will write the names. See wherever you remove hydrogen, that is first carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is called pentyl. Now next, come here, I removed at second carbon. Wherever you remove hydrogen, that carbon is first carbon. One, longest chain we need to consider, 2, 3, 4. This is the longest chain. Now substituent present at first carbon, that is methyl group, 1-methyl butyl. You should understand, students, very important. Now I removed hydrogen from third carbon, that's why this is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. I am selecting longest continuous chain, and one substituent present at first carbon, that is ethyl group, 1-ethyl one ethyl propyl. This is the process to give name of IUPAC nomenclature. So I discussed what is alkane and what is alkyl group, and their IUPAC names also we given. Now next category is rules for IUPAC name of organic compounds. See how which rules we need to follow to construct IUPAC name of the organic compound. The first rule is what? Selection of principal chain. Which is longest continuous chain, or which is parent chain, or which is principal chain. For that, some rules are there. To select principal chain, total 3 rules are there. One by one we will discuss. The first rule is select the longest continuous chain in a given organic compound. Any organic compound if you have, so we need to do what? To select principal chain, first longest continuous chain we need to consider. See 1 2 3 4 5. See if you go to down 1 2 3 4, from here if you go down only 4 carbons are there. If you go up, if you go straight, 5 carbons we will get. So that's why this is the longest continuous chain, this is the principal chain. Now come to next one. See here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, this is the longest continuous chain. This is the longest continuous chain, students. Now next second rule is what? If compound contains more than one longest chain, if compound contains more than one longest chain with equal number of carbon atoms, so our condition is what? You need to consider very properly here and concentrate, students. If compounds containing more than one longest chain with equal number of carbon atoms, then what we need to do? Selection of longest chain which has more number of locands. Which has more number of locands. Look here, how can I select? See, first example I taken 2. This is 1 and this is 1. Now look here. If I select straight forward, left to right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now come here. I will select longest continuous chain, one more root. Same compounds, these two are 1, 4, 5, 6, 7. See, I selected two roots. One is left to right, straight forward, and other one is left to upper side. So both are longest continuous chain with equal number of carbon atoms. In this case, which one is principal chain? Which one is principal chain? This is very important. What we said, whatever the longest chain contains more locands, that is principal chain. Here one locand, two locands. Here total how many locands are there? Two locands are there. Come here, this is one locand, this is one locand, this is one locand. Total 3 locands are there. So that's why it is our principal chain. It is not our principal chain. I hope you following, students. Now one more example I will take it. 1 2 3 4 5, and one more root I am selecting that. 1 2 3 4 5. See here, this is our longest continuous chain, this is our longest continuous chain. Both are longest continuous chain with same number of carbon atoms. Then which longest chain come to principal chain? I already told you, more locands if present. Here 2 locands and here only 1 locand. So that's why it is our principal chain, it is not our principal chain. Now next last third rule to select principal chain: if compound contains functional group, multiple bonds and locands. If compound contains functional group, multiple bonds and substituents, then parent chain should be with functional groups and multiple bonds. Functional groups and multiple, in our longest chain, in our parent chain, in our principal chain, what we should have? Functional groups and multiple bonds. So note here, one note is there. In this case, longest chain rule may or may not be violated.
See, while selecting principal chain, longest chain rule may or may not be violated. Why? Because here condition is what? Functional group and multiple bonds must and should in parent chain. So come here, students. I will give the numbering. Here two compounds are same. Which one is correct? We will select now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here one more I am giving that numbering priority. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here longest continuous chain. Sir, here longest continuous chain is there. That's why it is the principal chain. No, it is not principal chain. Why? Because functional groups not in parent chain. But here functional group is in parent chain. That's why it is our parent chain, principal chain. I hope you understood. Now come to one more example. I will select three different routes. This is one route, and one more route is, this is one route, and one more other route is this straight route. So you guess, students, which is principal chain. Now I will give the numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now come to here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 only. Now come here. 1, 2, 3, 4 only. Then what you expect? This is principal chain. No, it is not principal chain. Why? Because functional group not in parent chain. Now come here. Sir, this is the longest chain. No, it is also not principal chain. Why? Because here functional group is came, but multiple bond not came. Now come here. This is correct. Why? Functional group and multiple bond present at parent chain. That's why it is principal chain. So these three rules are over. Three rules are there to select principal chain. One is longest continuous chain. After that, what we need to check? Our longest chain must have more number of locants. Next rule is what? Our longest continuous chain must have functional groups and multiple bonds. In this case, longest chain rule may or may not be violated. Next, second, naming of principal chain. So what we did in first case, principal chain selected. Now what we are doing? Naming of the principal chain. Now look here, while naming of the principal chain, how many rules are there? 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 rules are there. One by one we will discuss. The first rule is what? While naming the principal chain, principal chain is numbered from one end to other end by Arabic numericals. I already given in previous case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. In such a way, the substituent should get lowest possible number. See, if our principal chain has substituents, then while giving the numbering, our substituents should get lowest number. See here, if I give number from like this, these two are same examples. Now consider one of the example. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now which route is correct? So I am telling that this route is correct, this route is wrong. Why, sir? Our substituent getting lowest number. Here our substituent getting highest number. So next, one more example is there. Now look here, students, one more example is what? See here, I forgot that while selecting the principal chain, one more example we need to consider. Now two routes I will find, which route is correct you need to tell. Now this is one more rule. Now look here, give numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sir, 7 carbons are there, so that's why this is the principal chain. No, it is not principal chain. Why? Functional group came, but where is the multiple bond? Here, this is the multiple bond and functional group in parent chain. That's why it is principal chain. Now, come to our rule. Now, what is our, while naming the principal chain, what is our first rule? Arabic numbers we need to give from one end to other end, in that, in such a way substitution should get lowest number. Now look students, 2 roots I will find, which root is correct you need to tell. 1 2 3 4, next 1 2 3 4, here substitution at second position, here substitution at third position, which is correct? This is correct, this is wrong. Now next one. Now next second rule, lowest set of locands or lowest sum rule. See here, our principal chain has many substituents. While giving the Arabic numericals, substituents should follow lowest sum rule. See, I will give with example 1 2 3 4 5. Now 1 2 3 4 5, I given numbers. So before going to calculate, what I given the point, you look one time. If parent chain has more than one substituents, then then some of the position of locand should be low. Then some of the position of the locand should be low. Now look here. Here 1 2 3 substituents are there. 1 2 3 substituents are there. Now one of the substituent at second position 2+, and one more substituent at third position 2 substituents are there. Total 3 plus 2 3 3 6 plus 2 8. Now come here. Now 3 plus 3 plus 4, 10 is there. Lowest sum rule which followed, it is followed lowest sum rule. That's why it is the correct way while naming the functional group, while naming the principal chain. It is wrong method. Now come to one more example. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Now 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, here substituent at second position and fifth position, here substituents at sixth position and third position. 3 plus 6 9. Now here 2 plus 5 7. So it is not followed. Now third rule, if different alkyl groups are present on parent chain, different alkyl groups are present on parent chain in identical position, then similar groups, simpler groups or smaller groups should get lowest number. Simpler groups or smaller groups should get lowest number. Now look here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here methyl and ethyl. Methyl and ethyl. It is smaller or simpler. It is smaller or simpler. Smaller or simpler. Now smaller group at third position, here smaller group at fifth position. What I said, smaller group should get lowest number. So this is the correct way of representation. It is wrong way of representation. I hope you are following, students. Next, fourth one. If multiple bonds are present on parent chain, then multiple bonds should get lowest number. Now look, students, I will give the number 1 2 3 4 5 1 2 3 4 5. So which root is correct? Here multiple bond get at second position, here multiple bond get at third and fourth position. This is correct, this is wrong. Now 1 1 2 3 4 5, next 1 2 3 4 5. So 2 3 position, 3 4 position, it is right and it is wrong. Now next 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Now should concentrate more, students. Here second position is there, fourth position is there, here sixth position is there, multiple bonds. Now here first position is there, third position is there, plus fifth position is there. So this is correct, this is wrong. That is correct and this is wrong. So students, you need to follow carefully. So 2 plus 4 4 plus 2, how much? Next example, look here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So multiple one got first number and multiple number got fourth position. This is correct. This is wrong. Next one, fifth rule. If double bonds and triple bonds are present on the parent chain in identical position, then double bond should get lowest number. Now very simple. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or array multiple bonds at same place, double bond and triple bond at same place. Then which one should get lowest number? Double bond should get lowest number. Here double bond got first position. Here double bond got fourth position. So this is correct. This is wrong. Now next, sixth point. If functional groups, multiple bonds and substituents are present on parent chain, then functional group should get lowest number. See, functional group, multiple bonds and substituents are present at on parent chain, then functional group should get lowest number. Now look here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So functional group getting fourth number, functional group getting first number. This is correct. This is wrong. So next example. See here, functional group is there. Here multiple bond is there. So both should get in parent chain. Both should get in parent chain. So in this, which name is correct? We will see now. It is not functional group. It is primary prefix. Sorry, it is secondary prefix. It is substituent. So that's why 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which one is correct? Multiple bond getting lowest number. So that's why it is correct. It is wrong. Here multiple bond only functional group. This is not functional group. This is only substituent. I already given you secondary prefix rule. Now last rule. If carbon containing functional group, all what? CHO. Oic acid means what? COOH. And OH means what? COOR. And oil halide means what? COX. And amide is what? CONH2. And nitrile is what? CN. This type of functional groups, if carbon containing function, these are the carbon containing functional groups are present in organic compound, then the numbering starts from that functional group only. These functional groups are called terminating functional groups. So if carbon containing functional groups are present on parent chain, then your number, you should start from functional group only. So you don't start numbering from here. This is wrong. So you should start numbering from where? From functional group carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. You should follow this rule. Why? Because here multiple bond also present. You should not go right side. You should go to left side. So this is the way of naming of principal chain. Sorry, I called always naming, not naming, numbering. So first rule is what? Selection of principal chain. Next rule is what? Naming of, numbering of principal chain. Next, third rule is what? Naming of substituents and alphabetical order. So our video length is too large. That's why I will discuss this in next class. Thank you.